I know we have a lot of young people listening in or watching, and you know, you're a seasoned entrepreneur in many businesses. What advice would you have for like young people who are considering, like, how do I financially make myself better?
It's never going to happen working for somebody else. Yeah. I mean, let's call a spade, right? Like, let's quit fucking around, because a lot of people are still going to, like, school does not serve men. Mm. Everything in post-secondary education does not, it doesn't teach men the way that men learn. It doesn't benefit them, you know, the way they need to be benefited to receive the tools that they need for the outside world. The funny thing is, you know, when I started doing this YouTube stuff, a lot of people started putting in the comments completely unsolicited. You know, there's a pattern. It's like, Rich, you're like the father I never had. Mm. And I'm like, where is this coming from? Like, why am I the like this random guy that talks to a camera through a microphone on YouTube and uploads the same button as Casey Neistat and Ameer Rosic and everybody else? How is it that I've become the father that they never, it's because I'm telling them shit that they need to hear and that is completely absent from their belief system, right? So I help them understand those concepts so they can do better in the world. So it's like, you know, things like school, you know, we've heard this before, never let school get in the way of your education, right? Yeah. A lot of guys still do that.
Yeah.
You know, they still make choices that drag them. Like I was talking to this guy on Monday night. So I do this show like every other Monday nights on my channel. It's called Before the Train Wreck. And a lot of guys will call in during that segment and they'll ask questions, trying to avoid a potential train wreck because their spidey senses, you know, warn them of something coming. And there's this guy, you know, he's 29. He's been in school for whatever it is, 7 years. He's got another year left in his degree, but he fucking hates what he's doing. He doesn't even want to do it when he gets out of school, but it's his backup plan so he can have a J-O-B, right? Job, just over broke. Mm-hmm. It's really what it stands for. And it's like, well, dude, like, what do you like doing? Like, you know, what do you lose track of time when you're just like traveling and, you know, writing when I'm traveling and, you know, talking about these destinations and how to do certain things. It's like, then why are you taking this engineering degree when you're not even going to do anything with it? Or if you do do something with it, you're going to create a life for yourself that you hate. I'm like, dude, you only go through life once. Okay. As far as we know, you're dead. You're 6 foot under. You're done.
Yeah.
Maybe there's a bonus round afterwards. Yeah. Maybe there isn't. I don't know. But you only go through life once. So why are you fucking around making choices that aren't serving you?
I agree. My usual advice for, actually this applies to anybody if you're trying to figure out, I want to say financial freedom, but for you to get any form of freedom, you need to have knowledge, tool sets, and a belief system, mm-hmm. regardless of if getting in shape or making money or whatever. And, you know, this just through my own personal experience as well. It's like, I always tell people, listen, join a startup, get a job, join a startup. You'll learn more in a year or two than any other job anywhere else.
Lotto.
And go do some consulting on the side with the knowledge that you have. Mm-hmm. You're pretty much getting paid to learn other people's problems. Mm-hmm. And through this process, man, you can find out, you're getting paid way better money than working for anybody.
Yeah.
Number two, you are learning amazing skills that, fuck, like you would never learn on your own. And number three, this gives you an insight within the industry that you're focusing on to maybe solve a problem that an industry has.
Most guys are rudderless.
Right? Yeah.
20s. Like I've even talked to guys in their 40s that are completely rudderless. They don't know what to do. They don't know where they're going.
Yeah.
It's like the dead fish kind of like, you know, get pushed downstream sort of thing. Like that's how the vast majority of guys operate. I talk to guys mostly. So, you know, like a lot of this might apply to women too, but that's what I focus on, you know, as far as my demographics. And it's like, they're completely rudderless. They don't know what to do. They don't have a vision. They don't have any kind of purpose. And that's fine, you know, for a while. Mm-hmm. But if you've been doing it for 5 years, 7, 10, 12, 15 years, you got to be asking yourselves questions like, what the hell am I doing wasting my time on this? Right? Because before you know it, you're going to be 46. I just turned 46 this year, right? You're going to be 46. You're going to have a bad knee, right? You're going to start looking at like, shit, you know, I was really good at this 20, like your eyesight sucks. Like the reason why I'm
stem cells then.
Yeah, like, dude, the reason why I'm downtown today is because I went over to the clinic over on Yorkville and they're doing like a scan for a clear lens replacement.
Okay.
I had great vision when I was 25.
You ever consider laser or?
Well, laser doesn't work for my eyesight because of the farsightedness. Like I'm a plus 4.5 now.
Yeah.
So clear lens replacement is like the only viable solution. It's like, that's an intrusive surgery. Like this is shit that you end up with when you're 46, mm-hmm, right? Mm-hmm. So like time flies and guys waste it. Guys waste their time doing dumb things, working for people that they hate, doing jobs that they hate, being in relationships where they're abused or with women that they hate. They're just miserable, man.
I think it goes back to environment. Like if you look at, you know, I'm a firm believer free will doesn't exist and we are the product of our environment. Mm-hmm. It's mastering your environment creates a proper external triggers to master yourself. So
why do you say free will doesn't exist? Like why can't we become self-aware and say, no, I choose to be different?
When I say free will, like you look at—
Just being the devil's advocate.
Yeah, it's a good question. So a couple of things. One, there is a spectrum of Richard's behavior. Like a bell curve. It's not like binary where like Richard has zero choice. That's not what I'm saying. There is a natural behavior you've had your whole life. Mm. It starts with the substrate of your genetics, your DNA from your mom and dad, right? Mm. Then you have epigenetics or the software that programs how you behave from childhood. Now, if you look back in hindsight, regardless of if it's a good decision or a bad decision, there's a spectrum how you behave, right? There's a way that you're wired. And a person who does really good deep dive stuff is, you know, I'm Steven Sisler, behavioral disc profiling. Mm-hmm. And so you look at this bell curve, this spectrum. In a nutshell, every human being behaves in here. I'm not saying you don't have consciousness, but I'm saying you have innate characteristics, innate traits. No matter how hard you want to change it, you'll never change.
Yeah.
It's fundamentally a part of you.
Yeah, I would agree with that. I mean, there's a lot of guys that will take a look at their weaknesses.
Yeah.
And then they try to improve their weaknesses and all they end up with is really good weaknesses.
Yeah. Like it's ridiculous. Yeah. Like, fuck your weaknesses.
Yeah.
Focus on your strengths. So exactly. You figure out your strengths, like what your God-given gifts are.
Yeah.
And
then double down
the fuck on that and then figure out how your environment is conducive for that behavior.
Yeah. So I mean, like you do have a certain degree of ability to maneuver.
There's a spectrum.
And
there's a spectrum.
There is free will in there, but from a perspective of, I guess, you know, genetic editing and DNA and, you know, like a function of society with where you're at. Yeah, you're right. I mean, there's only so much will that you can exert in direction, but it's like you're stuck in you're on a highway and you got four lanes.
Yeah.
Which lane you want to go in sort of thing. You can't just kind of like drive off on the road sort of thing.
I'll give you an example of the phone. You have the hardware and no matter how better the software becomes, mm-hmm. it's still conducive to the substrate of the phone hardware.
It's still an Android,
It's still an Android.
Yeah.
Until I update the physical hardware, which in the future we might, with like CRISPR and gene editing. Yeah.
Well, it's the same thing with men and women, right?